Hello again. My name is Mike, and this is part two of our Instant Quote Form series. In part one, we covered the questions and conditional logic needed to come up with a thorough instant quote in Formidable Forms. In this part, we'll change the layout and design to make it much more appealing to fill out. And in the final part, we'll set it up to do the actual calculations needed to provide a quote. This is what our form looks like right now. Not terrible, but we can make it look much better. The first problem is everything is too big. We don't need every question to be so wide. Let's go back into our form and put two questions per row instead of one. We'll just drag this mold removal question next to the main deck or patio question. Easy. Now, if we look here in the CSS layout classes, there's something we should check out. FRM6 and FRM underscore first. FRM underscore first just means it will show up first in a row. But what about FRM6? Quick little lesson. Responsive websites are generally built in a 12-column grid. This is because 12 can be divided in half at 6, thirds by 4, quarters by 3, and sixths by 2. If you didn't notice, those are all whole numbers. Suck it, metric system. May the imperial foot measurement never die. Anyway, FRM6 means that this field will take up half the screen on a desktop or laptop. Both this field and the one next to it have that same FRM6 class. However, the way responsive websites work is they know on devices like a phone, 12 is too big. So instead, the phone will display things 6 wide. So each question will get its own row rather than getting smushed together. Pretty cool. And Formidable Forms automatically does this with drag and drop, so you can easily change things with a few clicks. This is already looking much better. Let's make the how many question 6 wide as well. We'll just type FRM6. But since this is a sub-question, and mold removal is a sub-question, what if we made all the sub-questions right-aligned? That way, when a user clicks yes on wanting something washed, it's immediately visually apparent what new questions they'll need to fill out. But how do we right-align a field? Just go down here and click Write. Done. It's really that easy. So now I'm going to go through all the sub-questions and make them 6 wide and right aligned. I'll speed it up so it won't take as long. Done. This looks great. First problem solved. The second problem, at least for me, is standard radio buttons are boring. What if we made them actual buttons instead? We'll select the first question and click Buttons under Radio Buttons Options. There we go, that's looking better. They still seem too big though. Let's click Advanced, and we'll change one column to two column in the option layout. That looks a lot better. I'll do the same to all the fields, and then click Update to save. Let's check out what it looks like on our test page. I like it. This is looking great. But let's see if we can make a few changes to make it pop, like add some color. And I realize now, some of the styling here has actually already been changed. It must be borrowing some styling changes that happened when my friend created his contact page. Let's go to the Formidable Styler and create a new style we'll call Estimate. Then we'll go to Manage Styles and we'll assign our new estimate style to our estimate form. Let's click Update and check out our form. Yep. Okay, we're back to absolute default. Let's go back to the styler and make sure we're working on our new estimate style. We'll start with sections. My buddy's business colors are a light blue and a dark blue, so I'll be using those. We'll make the section headings his light blue, and let's make them bigger. I don't like how much space there is between the sections, so I'll remove the top margin and cut the bottom margin by half. I also don't like that line that separates them, so I'll get rid of the border. I want to make everything a little bigger, so let's make the fields themselves a little bigger. 50 height, 18 font. I'll do the same with our field labels and field description, and I'll change the color of our description to the dark blue color for the business. Let's go to Toggles, and change the on color to our light blue. I want to make the buttons bigger as well. We'll change the default light blue to the light blue my buddy's business uses, and then change the text color to black since it's such a light color. Now, this is very much a personal opinion, but I like a flat look, so I'm going to get rid of the border on the buttons too. I'll change the hover color to the dark blue and the hover text to white. Now, this is important. The buttons style area only affects buttons like next or submit. It does not affect radio buttons that are styled like actual buttons. Those are set to be the same color as your field background color. And this is the kind of weird part, when selected, they're set to be the same color as the active background color under progress bars and root line. I'm fine with white for a field color. I'll change the active background to a very light gray and our active border to the dark blue. Then we'll change the active background color under progress bars and root line to light blue. Awesome. One final thing. We haven't gotten there yet, but we're going to want to personalize our on submit message to show the quote. Let's go into form messages and make it a dark blue text, 24 size font. We want it to stand out. Let's update this and then check it out on our test page. It looks good. Let's check out the second page. Also good. It looks really good, actually. I'm excited. Now I've just got to make this thing actually give a quote, but that's for the next video. Subscribe for more Formidable Forms and WordPress tips, or just to make sure you don't miss part 3 when we actually get into the form calculations, and I'll see you next time.